DC Sports. Today, Mike Krzyzewski, whose teams have made the Final Four twice in the last 3 years, his Blue Devils are 14-4, take on Digger Phelps and the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Young Notre Dame, a solid 12-3. From the Athletic and Convocation Center, college basketball is brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer. By new Michelob Dry, one taste and you'll drink it dry. By the U.S. Army, learn how to get an edge on life. Be all you can be. And by today's Howard Johnson, we're changing a lot of minds. Part of the pregame psychology, Digger Phelps bringing his young team through the student body as they ready themselves for an important early February contest, an annual affair now between the Irish and the Blue Devils of Duke University. The Irish without a senior, the youngest team ever for Digger Phelps, and Duke trying to come back after that 13-0 start, Al McGuire, when they were number one in the nation. They've lost 4 of 5. We're going to see two of the best shooting and best rebounding teams in the nation. They're both in the top 15.
Well, you know what happened this morning, Dick? I went down in the hotel trying to meet Coach K and rap with the staff. And I walked into their pregame meal. I looked around. There was such a silence. I turned around and walked out. This is an emotional game. This is no fooling around. They're down to business. Duke wants this game. I look for some technical foul. Notre Dame wants it because they're ending a seven-game home streak and want to get on the road with a win. And Notre Dame needs another quality win.
We're going to see two quality big men inside. Danny Ferry, the All-America, leading the ACC in scoring for Duke University. And for Notre Dame, their freshman, LaPhonso Ellis.
LaPhonso Ellis brings the start of a new dynasty. He can do everything, but he's what you call like a bell cow. You can recruit off him and end up with a dynasty 3-4 years down the line.
Ellis from the St. Louis area, leading Notre Dame in scoring and rebounding. They've never had a freshman accomplish that feat, doubling up as the top scorer and top board man, and we'll have the starting lineups in just a moment.
My son Tom got a front-wheel drive Cutlass Supreme SL with FE3 suspension because tests proved that the new T-Bird LX and Cougar LS couldn't handle a curve this fast.
And Tom just loves those sharp, tough curves.
This is Tom, your father's Oldsmobile.
How'd you like that fastball, Dad?
This is the new generation.
Yeah, I call for a curve.
I'm not going to sit here and tell you AT&T's long-distance rates are competitive. I'm going to prove it to you. If you're with another long-distance company and your business spends at least $120 a month, call us about our discount calling plans, AT&T Pro Watts. If you qualify, here's the deal. We'll pay for the sign-up fee, the switch-over charge, and if within 3 months you're not completely satisfied with our quality, value, and price, we'll even pay to switch you back. So what have you got to lose? Even the call is free. 1-800-222-0400. Pick up the phone. Call us.
If you want to land a good job, you have to know what most employers want. Like how to motivate yourself, how to lead others, how to perform under pressure. You can learn all these things in the Army. So no matter what career you choose, you'll really be ready to take off.
Midwinter slump, 4 losses in the last 5. We'll start John Smith instead of Robert Bricky at forward today. Danny Ferry with 22 points a game, the leading scorer for the Devils. Ala Abdelnaby, this young center. Henderson and Quinn Snyder in the backcourt. Notre Dame lost only 3. LaPhonso Ellis, the brilliant freshman, Jameer Jackson had his best game against Marquette on Wednesday night. Scott Paddock starts instead of Keith Robinson at center. Joe Frederick just behind Ellison, scoring in Tim Singleton, their playmaker and top defensive player. Frederick, Smith, and Jackson. We've got Paddock on Ferry.
Look for Smith to shoot from the outside.
Henderson off balance. Tip in by Aldunabi. Jameer Jackson brings it in for the Irish in their yellow uniforms.
It's a five count almost.
Henderson, Frederick around him, passes to Paddock. And Ellis could not convert, out of bounds to Notre Dame. At the Joyce Athletic and Convocation Center this year, 8-1. They've lost only 52 times in 21 years, the Irish. Turnover, and Quinn Snyder with quick hands feeds it ahead to Henderson. No look pass to Aldunabi, and Duke leads 4-0.
Allen needed those two baskets. He's been in a little bit of a drought. He needed his confidence.
Singleton, and it's Ferry comes up with the ball. A couple of turnovers, and Duke with a chance to take a quick, sizable early lead. Snyder has it knocked away. No, he touched it last. Good defense by Tim Singleton.
Here comes a no-look pass coming down the court here. Gives that head fake, and Allah has all inside.
Full pressure by Duke. Singleton from New Orleans, Carver High School, brings it in. Frederick. 4-2 is Joe Frederick. For Notre Dame.
1-2-1-1 zone press. They break it. It's broken.
Aldunabi has all six of the Devils' points, and it's Duke by 4. 2 minutes gone.
Got to get that last two to Danny Ferry. It was the pass that did it, Dick.
Inside to Paddock. Scott Paddock from Plantation, Florida. His first bucket. Aldunabi has it deflected, and Ferry saves. Underneath, Aldunabi again, and he has 8 points, and he is fouled by Paddock. What a start for Allah Aldunabi early this year. Speaking of starts, in the first 4 games, he made 20 consecutive field goals, an ACC record. This is the kind of play that he showed the Blue Devil fans in the early part of the year.
Well, what's happening, they're paying too much attention to Ferry, and Aldunabi's free underneath. I think I'm better off if I just call him Allah.
Allah Aldunabi, the servant of the prophets.
Well, the kids at school call him the Pharaoh.
He's a 5A player, A-L-A-A, and 2 A's in his last name.
There for Robert Bricky, who's just come in, so it remains 8-4. Duke leading 2.5 minutes into the game.
Duke playing hard man-to-man.
Singleton not there. Rebound Aldunabi, clears to Snyder. Stolen by Paddock. 2-on-3 the other way. Singleton. Ellis. Alfonso Ellis, the brilliant freshman from East St. Louis, makes it 8-6. He's averaging 15 a game.
And he's shopping the baselines like money in the bank.
Danny Ferry yet to score. Here's his first shot, way short. Rebound Ellis. Here come the Irish. By the way, this Notre Dame team, number one in the nation in rebounding. Jameer Jackson can't hit it. Robert Bricky at 6'5", climbs the rebound.
Coach Cage real upset. Thought Danny Ferry got hit in the arm that last shot. I look for a couple of technicals called in this game.
Foul inside. It'll go against Notre Dame. Joe Frederick is first. Quinn Snyder
comes out. Abdelnaby out. Leitner in for Duke, as is Brian Davis. Keith Tower, a freshman from Pittsburgh, 6'11". Digger Phelps sends in for Scott Paddock. Bricky inside. Not there. Tipped out, and it's Notre Dame's ball. Alfonso Ellis with quick hands. Takes the shot. Leitner can't control. No foul. Irish fans thought there was one.
Looked to me like Bricky hit him that time. Fast pace.
Where does that favor, Notre Dame or Duke?
I think it favors Notre Dame.
Ferry with a soft kiss off the glass for his first bucket. 10-6 Duke.
The more they can get the crowd in the game, the more it works in the subconscious of the Zebras.
Singleton up the alley. Tim Singleton for Notre Dame makes it 10-8, his first basket. Berry to Christian Leitner. Back on top to Henderson. Leitner inside, and he pushed off. That'll be against the freshman from Duke, Christian Leitner. Good-looking prospect. And with that call, we have a timeout. 4.5 minutes into this first half. The score, Duke 10, Notre Dame 8.
This is a change. This is new. Howard Johnson, can this be you? This is Howard Johnson today. This is Howard Johnson today. Changing in so many colorful, comfortable, welcoming ways. This is Howard Johnson today. This is Howard Johnson today.
Our son James got this Cutlass Supreme SL because it has front-wheel drive, FE3 suspension, and because test proved the new T-Berg LX and Cougar LS just don't stop as fast. And James just loves a nice fast break.
This is not your father's automobile.
Go for it, Mom.
This is the new generation.
What's cooking at Wendy's? Our new Philly Swiss burger with fresh peppers, onions, and mushrooms. All on a Kaiser bun. Come on in and grab one while it's hot.
Oh, no matter what you do, that I'll be there for you.
New improved Kodak batteries last longer than ever. So when you need us, we'll be there.
You can be
six-time Player of the Year Tom Watson, Paul Azinger, and a field of golfing greats tee off at the Hawaiian Open next weekend on NBC.
Mike Krzyzewski, his team starting out 13-0, outscoring the opposition by 29, but in the last five, they've been outscored by three and won only one. That was against Clemson, a team that had half their club sitting on the bench. Discipline problems. Clemson came back and beat Carolina the next game. Joe Frederick gets the roll, and it's tied at 10. 4 points for Frederick.
Duke's doing a good job against the press.
Leitner inside. He's got way too much size in there for the man trying to stop him, and there's a foul. And on that matchup, Leitner had 7 inches. Foul goes to Tower.
There's a body for a freshman. Nobody will ever kick sand in his face.
He wants to be a broadcaster, so be nice to him.
Tower goes out. Alfonso Ellis rested briefly. Keith Robinson is now in. So Ellis and Robinson, Singleton, Frederick, and Jackson on the floor now for Notre Dame. Leitner breaks the tie with his first point. He's from Angola, New York. Went to Nichols School in Buffalo, where he averaged nearly 28 a game last year. And is averaging 7.5 this year. 12-10 Duke.
Everybody calls him Christian because he has a brother named Chris.
Leitner on the dribbler, Singleton. Inside. Jackson. Ellis misses the stuff. Jackson traveled. Ellis missed a relatively easy follow. Here comes Phil Henderson for the Blue Devils. Ricky can't handle the pass.
Ricky tried to make his move before he got the ball. Always wait for the ball. Step towards the ball when it's being thrown to you. With your eyes, you follow the ball into your hands.
Frederick, good move.
Give credit to LaFonso Ellis for the nice high pick.
Frederick with six to lead the Irish. Game tied, a dozen aside. Bounds off Danny Ferry, another turnover. Although Ferry thought the Irish either fouled him or went off a Notre Dame player.
What happened that time? It went off Danny Ferry's ankle or right foot.
Ferry out and Abdelnaby back in. Abdelnaby scored the first 8 points for Duke, just two under his average on the year.
Off the weak side where the ball is, and they block up the paint. They're down there in the blue. See where Henderson is in the blue? He's not guarding anybody. He's way off sweep. See how they are down there? There's the turnover.
Snyder picked it away, but it goes to Singleton, and Singleton still no whistle. And wide open is Robinson, but he can't make the shot. And Abdelnaby, he falls over. Robinson out of bounds to Notre Dame.
I told you it's going to be a physical game. I thought Notre Dame being number one in football, they'd be doing the diving. Never mind the Blue Devils are doing the diving.
No one has ever won the national championship in football and basketball the same year. Good move. Damon Sweet from Beaumont, Texas, a 6'5 freshman, gives Notre Dame the lead for the first time.
I don't think Coach K has spoke to these guys. Look at them diving for the ball on the floor. This game is take no prisoners. Nice inside position, puts up a prayer. Can't get his balance, goes out of bounds. Notre Dame ball.
Here's Sweet. Now you called him Nutra Sweet out at UCLA, and the student body doesn't like the nickname, so they're having a contest to re-nickname him.
He gets a very kind bounce off the brace of the rim, and Notre Dame leads by three. Danny Ferry returns.
How about Air Sweet? Now Nutra Sweet is right.
There's some other final nicknames in there. We'll give you an idea of what the students want to call it.
Danny Ferry and a whistle.
It's important that they get Danny Ferry off the snide. The snide means you haven't scored yet. Oh, I didn't know we had this.
There's some of the nicknames. Honeymoon, how about Presidential Suite? Or we got the Beat Suite. Sultan of Suite, a la Ruth. I kind of like Nutcracker Suite.
I like Honeymoon Suite. That's kind of special.
But those are the finalists as conducted by the student newspaper. Oh. Student body recommended those nicknames.
You know what's going to happen, Dick? You'll be called NutriSuite. It's important that Danny makes this. They have to get him on a scoring run.
And Ferry, who is a solid free throw shooter, but under considerably last year's 83%, shooting only 72% this year.
Well, it's not an excuse, but his back has been bothering him for about 3 weeks now.
Alfonso Ellis. And Ellis over the back with a foul. First on Ellis. And Duke will play it from the back court. We played 6 minutes and 45 seconds into the intense eyes of the retired Army captain, Mike Krzyzewski, who played and was captain of a Bobby Knight team at West Point. Snyder for three. Quinn Snyder gives Duke the lead, 16-15. His first points.
Might go back home for that Final Four in Seattle in late March.
Damon Sweet. Abdelnaby takes the rebound away from Ellis, and Ellis is called for the foul. His second.
Zebra Crew is from the ACC.
John Moreau, David Dodge, and Peter Pavia. has become an annual affair and a good one. Remember, 3 years ago, it came down to the final shot, and David Rivers' chance to win it was blocked. Then they went overtime here 2 years ago, and Notre Dame won. And last year, a tightly contested game at Duke, and the Blue Devils were victorious. Ferry from outside. Rebound to Frederick. Notre Dame, trailing by one, brings it in. Christian Leitner is going to come in for Abdelnaby. And Jameer Jackson back in for Notre Dame for Joe Frederick. And Elmer Bennett, peeling off his jersey, is going to come in shortly for Notre Dame. A little out of his range, and John Smith has the rebound for Duke. Snyder, long toss to Ferry.
What a pass to Leitner.
And Leitner tripped as he goes in. Entangled with Scott Paddock. Second foul on Paddock. Boy, that looked like it was going to be a disaster. He was headed right for the protective padding around the backboard. Watch this. Luckily, he didn't have enough momentum going forward. And no injury.
Paddock is expendable, the same with Towers, so they'll give their 10 fouls. I would say that both of them will be fouled out of the game before the game is over.
Here's Leitner. Early in the season, he hit 14 straight shots. Not bad for a rookie. His third point all on free throws.
He's from upstate New York, around Rochester.
Buffalo.
Buffalo, near the Buffalo.
He's 4 for 4 from the line. 12 minutes to go, first half. Duke leading Notre Dame 18-15. Paddock on the side and Sweet. Damon Sweet. He now has 5.
There's the 1-2-1-1. Here's the one man in the back of the zone.
Beautiful pass, but a charging foul. No basket. Against Leitner. Behind the back pass by Snyder set it up.
I thought it was a good call, Dick. Let's see. Here we go. His feet are planted. Made the contact before he released the ball. Good call.
No timeout with 11:41 remaining in the half. Duke by one.
My son, Icky, got this Cutlass Supreme SL because it has front-wheel drive, FE3 suspension, and because tests proved that the new T-Bird LX and Cougar LS just couldn't run the slalom as fast. That kid, he's got all the moves.
This is not your father's automobile.
I learned it from you, Mom.
This is the new generation.
This is a machine built for absolute dependability. And these are its hardest working parts. Each meeting the highest performance standards, providing continuous, reliable service. The mechanics of American Airlines. Uncompromising professionals dedicated to perfection. Flight after flight after flight.
Recently, Diet Coke has been presenting some hard-to-understand statistics. Diet Pepsi now brings you the facts. Last year, 2 million families stopped buying Diet Coke, and over 1 million new families started buying Diet Pepsi. So what's giving Diet Coke such a distorted view?
Gentlemen, I trust we're all seeing this the same way.
The real move is to Diet Pepsi.
Next weekend, come home to all the excitement of college basketball. Saturday, the 1988 national champion Kansas Jayhawks battle the Missouri Tigers, or Florida meets Kentucky. Then next Sunday, the running rebels of UNLV battle NC State. College basketball, it's the stuff weekends are made of on NBC Sports.
Welcome back to Notre Dame. A big win for the Hoyas on the road at the Spectrum in Philly. Florida early, two up on Mississippi. Georgia, point ahead of Kentucky in the first half. Illinois, four ahead of Iowa. And Arizona, with only two losses. There's some people would vote for them number one in the country if they beat Washington. Leitner with the rebound. Snyder with Duke leading 18-17. 11 and a half minutes remaining in the first half. Good pressure defense by the Irish. Paddock all over Ferry. Nice pass to Henderson, and that's the strength of Ferry. He leads the team in scoring with 22, but he's so unselfish and such a... He's a passer a la Larry Bird. Jameer Jackson with a fine drive, and it's 20-19. Jackson's first points. Nice bounce pass. Bricky scores, and it's 22-19 as Robert Bricky has his first hoop. Jackson along the baseline. Henderson hawking him. Over Bennett to Jameer. And on the wrist was Quinn Snyder. First foul on Snyder. Digger Phelps, the winningest coach in Notre Dame history with 356 victories. Put that in perspective for you a bit later in regard to some of the great winning football coaches here at Notre Dame. At the line, Jameer Jackson. Rockne, Leahy, Parsegian, Devine, they totaled 340. And Digger has 356.
Lock out.
Throwing Holtz, and the football coaches beat him. Holtz's wins, including his great national championship team of this year. No call, and then very, very short on the shot. Paddock ahead to Singleton. Frederick around Smith. And Abdelnaby.
Al's been doing a great job off the glass.
Ricky. Foul is against Ricky for charging. Player control. His second.
Here comes Bricky, definite charge. If that ball would have went in, it would have been good. He released it before.
Well, 22-20, Duke leading at the midpoint of this first 20-minute period. Duke and its patented tough man-to-man defense.
Snyder's been doing a good job on Singleton. Singleton doesn't want to shoot.
Robinson does, misses, gets his own rebound. And Abdelnaby tied up on the floor, and the arrow points to Notre Dame. Mike Krzyzewski on his feet thought there was a foul, and he's really working the officials. Basket away from another tie, and there it is. No, Robinson misses the layup, and Ferry rebounds, and a foul on Robinson.
Robinson was so upset about missing that chippy that he overreacted once Dan Ferry got inside.
Second foul on Keith Robinson.
I'm sorry, Dick. I have a problem with my earphones. I'm here in the truck, so if I'm losing you, I'm sorry.
Might be more interesting in there.
Yeah,
but you can
like
handle the language.
Coop inside the truck.
At the line for Duke is Danny Ferry. Each year, a great player out of high school. In fact, the National High School Player of the Year at the Matha and the Washington.
Washington, D.C. area, and each year he's improved part of his game. The experience of that first year improved his rebounding, improved his free throw shooting. This year he's improved his field goal percentage up to 56% after 47% last year.
He's in the hunt for the most valuable player at the present time, I'd say, between Ellison at Louisville and King at
King.
Oklahoma and Danny Ferry.
Frederick with only Ferry to beat.
He'll go right at him. Nice play by Frederick.
And he makes the hoop. 24-22.
Hey, you little guys out there, when you're going against a big guy, you're on a breakaway like that, go right at him. The big guy can't react to you.
Ferry over the freshman tower. That's an NBA move.
That should start him on a run.
7 points now for Danny Ferry, a four-point Duke lead at the nine-minute mark remaining in the first half.
Double stack down low for Notre Dame.
Singleton called for the charge. Snyder had defensive position. He's very clever at drawing that foul. Freshman Leitner in. And Brian Davis in for Duke. And Krzyzewski and Digger Phelps trying to keep a fresh five on the floor.
Coach K trying to keep the student body out of this game. He's done it so far.
John Smith. Jackson all over him. Leitner is tied up, and that'll go to Duke. Arrow to Duke.
You talk about sumo wrestlers. Tower was in there.
What a horrible call.
Coach K just said, what a horrible call.
Danny Ferry will trigger the inbounds pass. Smith, Ryan Davis. Ferry, turnaround this time. Boy, shows you the jump hook, and then he comes around with a fall away going the other direction. 9 points for Ferry. The All-America gives Duke its biggest lead, 6 points.
Inside, outside, playing with a bad back. The Duke people told me that they've got calls from acupuncturists, chiropractors, masseurs. Everyone want to work on his back. I think he's better keeping those needles out of his back. Let time do it.
I asked him before the game. He says he feels fine now after having to sit out a game. That was the start of the slump for Duke when they went on to lose four of these last five. Frederick for three. Good rebound by Paddock and Ricky. No, it's Davis who fouled him. Brian Davis.
Gives Scott Carter pat in the back for a hustle.
Seventh team foul on the Devils, and so both teams now in the bonus. Duke with 11 less shots than Notre Dame in this game. At the line for Digger Phelps is Scott Paddock, the 6'9 junior. Long line of Digger bulk run type players inside. That's his third point. That's his average.
Those go back to Lambeer
and Kempton.
Lambeer certainly made the career in the pros, hasn't
he though? He's been a better pro player than a collegiate. 28-24. Duke by four. 8 minutes to go. Picking up Ferry at midcourt. Ferry goes right around him and sets up Leitner, the freshman. What a nice play.
What a play that time. Tower drifted off Leitner, the double team Ferry, and it's almost like it. Watch this pass. He goes around Paddock. There goes Tower. Leitner's open free.
And simple. Paddock gets his third foul.
Simple Simon shot.
But he is, when you talk about an All-America basketball player, passing, rebounding, shooting, free throw shooting, defense, I mean, he is the complete guy, isn't he?
Plus leadership on and off the court, in the classroom, everything.
Leitner, 5 for 5 from the line, has 7 points for Duke. And the Devils' lead is up to 7. 8 minutes to go in the half.
Need a basket this time down to fight the Irish.
Power to Frederick. Anderson on him. Good move by Frederick, and then he throws away. Last touch by Leitner. He got a finger on it.
And with that stoppage of the clock, we'll take a timeout. 7 minutes and 41 seconds left in the opening half.
You know what moms are like. Bring home a new guy, they put their foot down. Come home a little late, they put their foot down. My mom's no different. I get this great new Oldsmobile Cutlass Cali with a quad 4 engine. And what does she do? You got it.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
I put my foot down. Uh-oh.
This is new generation of...
Express Mail from your post office offers you 46,000 drop-off points.
We deliver, we deliver.
A guaranteed morning delivery. And an overnight price of just $8.75.
We deliver, we deliver.
Speed, convenience, price. It's a package only we can deliver. Express Mail from your postal service.
We deliver for you.
Your life is changing, and State Farm is there.
I'm State Farm agent Jim McConnell. Terry Saylor's life insurance started out pretty simple. Then there were 3 children, 2 new mortgages, a big job promotion for Terry, and for Mrs. Saylor, a life plan of her own. 7 updates in just 6 years. State Farm agents are there to start you out with life insurance that works for you.
And like a good neighbor.
And we're there to keep it working for you.
State Farm is there.
If you've ever dreamed the dream of a champion, now your sports fantasy may come true on NBC Sports World.
If you've ever dreamed the dream of a champion, now your sports fantasy may come true on NBC Sports World next Sunday.
And they're both on the bench. Freshman Ellis and Junior Robinson, top 2 scorers for Notre Dame, are only 1-4-10 in this first half. It's reflected on the scoreboard as Duke leads by 7 at 31-24. Out of bounds, Tower. Either he dribbled on the sidelines or his foot was out of bounds. And Duke on the turnover goes the other way.
Duke's had no problem with up-court pressure.
Berry setting up Leitner. Look at Digger up. He's working the officials at that end. And a whistle. Henderson apparently got a piece of the wrist as he went up for that rebound. His first foul. You have the feeling that the officials are really tightening up on the calls, don't you, with both the coaches up on their feet working them hard in a physical game.
You have to, because of the physical game. And Paddock and Tower, they both are in the area of 6'9", 6'10", but the bodies they have, that puts them up to about 7'1", 7'2". But their space seaters, they take up so much room.
Again, the 3 officials are from the Atlantic Coast Conference, Duke's home conference. Paddock looking for his 5th point.
Well, the same way next year when Notre Dame plays down at Cameron Stadium, it'll be 3 Big Ten officials if Notre Dame uses the Big Ten.
Alfonso Ellis back in for Digger Phelps, and Keith Tower comes out. This Paddock, you talk about a young man, already a good citizen, 20-year-old junior. He's part of the South Bend Big Brother program, has a little brother, and age 12, and he says he's learning a lot about life from that 12-year-old adopted brother. Gets it back. Shooting good. Jameer, 2-point play. Becomes a 3-point play with a free throw and a field goal, and it's a 4-point Duke lead at 31-27.
Notre Dame goes to a zone. First time today, a true zone, 2-3.
Duke has the outside shooters. Snyder goes for 3.
Allah kept that ball alive that time, kept it alive again. It was last hit by Notre Dame.
Well, that was a real volleyball game, wasn't it? Everything but the spike. At halftime, rules of the game, basket interference, and Sean Bradley, he's that 7-foot-4-inch high school junior in Utah, will be the feature.
A representative high school ball player, Dick. He's not a person just because he's 7-foot-4.
Danny Ferry, tipped in by Abdelnaby, who has his average 10 points. The
of the Blue Devils, in case you joined us late. Out of bounds to Notre Dame.
Joe Frederick's my type of player. He thought he got hit that time.
Remember a couple of years ago down... It was last year at Duke when he came off the bench, scored 23. Ferry with a steal, one-on-one. Henderson against Frederick. Good move. Phelps wanted traveling, didn't get it, and Phil Henderson has his fourth point. And Duke his biggest lead.
Henderson gave him a blacktop move. We call that a 360.
Jameer Jackson. What a twisting move by Jackson in with a big freeze.
Jameer has a weakness, is his outside shooting. If you let him penetrate, he'll destroy you.
But we're only 6'2". He really plays big. Ferry. Oh, my.
Danny, baby. He looked fresh to pass. He wasn't opening the shot. He put it sky high and went in.
11 now for Ferry to lead Duke. Jameer again with a drive. Not this time. Gets his own rebound at 6'2". 9 points for Jameer Jackson. 37-31. Duke leads 5 minutes and 20 seconds left, first half. Smith.
He can hit from there.
Three-pointer, and it's 40-31. Duke's biggest advantage.
First 3 years, Smith played inside. But on the European tour this last summer, they played 10 games in Europe, only won 3. They found out that Smith could hit from the outside.
Nice pass. The Paddock was stuck. With 7 points. That's one of his best games of the year.
Bob Cousy was a pass before Bird and Magic made it famous.
Henderson gets a loose ball and scores. Joel Henderson, and Duke's back on top by 9 again. 6 for him. Singleton. Tim Singleton inside for his fourth point.
The ref, Smith stepped in.
Go back to Singleton's pass.
I call the Cousy pass. That's from many, many years ago, but Bird and Magic made it famous. That was Singleton. Used his peripheral vision and hit Paddock on the baseline. Forgive me.
Ryan Davis comes in for Phil Henderson. And Damon Sweet is in for Notre Dame, replacing Jameer Jackson. Joe Frederick, he had a game Wednesday night, or Thursday night, and beating Marquette, he didn't score a point in the first half. He scored 20 in the second half. Rebound, Ricky.
I'll tell you something, Dick. He played hard both halves. That's the type of person he is.
Ryan Davis, no one picks him up. Power got a piece of the shot from behind. Notre Dame with the ball and a 7-point deficit.
Alone, letting him down court. Leitner, you're a big man. Don't cover those guards.
Oops, Damon Sweet. No one there for the pass, so that's a backcourt violation as soon as it's touched. Ball to Duke. And a timeout. 3 minutes and 28 seconds remaining here at the Joyce Athletic and Convocation Center. Duke by 7.
You hear the thunder.
You can see it in the way it looks. You can feel it in the way it drives. This is America's premier sports coupe, Grand Prix.
Get off your pony, I can ride it home.
And now is a great time to check out Grand Prix with GMAC financing as low as 4.9% or up to $1,600 cash back on select Grand Prix for qualified first-time buyers.
We build excitement.
See your dealer for details today.
From now on, this is what dry is. Dry is a beer that starts bold from the first taste, finishes clean with no aftertaste, and refreshes completely. Dry is a beer called Michelob Dry. One taste, and you'll drink it dry.
To create new worlds, you need to see in new ways. Be curious. Look at the problem from another direction. Commit yourself to the long term. Keep your mind open. Look for breakthrough ideas. From aerospace to healthcare, we're creating new worlds by seeing in new ways. BASF, the spirit of innovation.
To Notre Dame. The Blue Devils using their inside game. Their big men have been the key. How does this Duke team at this stage compare with the clubs that, well, they were in the Final Four two of the last 3 years?
Well, the last 3 years, they lost the eventual champion of the NCAA. I think they missed Billy King, that defensive stopper, and also Strickland scoring from the outside. He used to average about 16 points a game. This club is good. You know what could be happening? Their fans could be a little spoiled. You know, they've had so much success, two out of the last 3 years in the Final Four, outstanding. And they could be back this year to Seattle.
Danny Ferry hits again. That's 13 for Ferry to lead all scores. 3 minutes and 11 seconds to go in this first half.
They won't let the Fighting Irish close the gap.
Frederick, a good fake. Hit the 10-footer and a foul as Smith came down with a rebound. No, Henderson came down with a rebound, and Keith Tower got a piece of him. Halftime score, Florida by 13 over Ole Miss. Georgia leads by 7 late in the first half against the Wildcats of Kentucky. Iowa, 7-point leader against Illinois, and two of the top 10 teams there.
Arizona could be number one this week. The two disappointing teams that played today this year has been Villanova, and the other one is Florida. Have not lived up to their expectations.
Bill Henderson has a group of family, mom and dad and grandparents here.
Stepped in too soon. I thought they would have blown the whistle then. They stepped in too soon. The ball wasn't released.
And they touched by Singleton out of bounds to Duke.
Coach Mike is yelling out there, hey, Dave, violation on the free throw.
Duke sitting on a 9-point lead, and Snyder goes for three more, way short. And Notre Dame comes the other way. Got to get Mofonzo Ellis into the offense. Tower has it knocked away by Leitner, and then Ferry, a baseball pass to Leitner, who gets two. Well done. Steve Spurrier would have liked that pass.
The only mistake is he threw the pass to the person and right up to the basket. It's a breakaway. Always throw the ball to the basket, not to the person.
Duke now by 11 at 46-35. Leitner scores again.
You better call a timeout, Notre Dame. There he is. Diggs calling one. A little bit late on that timeout. Diggs, I'll say there's going to be some technical, especially in the second half. Here. This, I believe, is one of the few mistakes Danny made. Instead of throwing it towards the basket, he threw it toward Leitner.
Leitner saved it, and the young freshman gets two there and gets two more. Now has 11 points in the game. So Ferry with 13, Leitner with 11, Abdelnaby with 10. That's 34 of Duke's 48 points coming from those big men inside. You don't usually see that happening against Notre Dame.
I didn't think that Oliver would have a good game today. It seems like the Nile's overflowing.
He was born in Egypt, moved with his family here in the United States at age 3, did Abdelnaby, and then attended Bloomfield, New Jersey High School, where he was the New Jersey High School Player of the Year. But young Christian Leitner there, you see in the huddle, he certainly has been a solid addition to this team.
He has ability to pass as a big man, but no one takes any notice because Danny Ferry is so good at it. As the years go by, one of the big things that people talk about Leitner is his passing ability.
And what an advantage, too, Coach, to be able as a freshman to practice every day against a guy like Ferry and learn all his tricks. Ferry leaves and you've got someone sitting right in his spot next year.
Well, Danny got most of his stuff from his father.
That's right, Bob Ferry, the general manager of the Bulls. another rebound. Clears to Henderson. Two on.
Good alley-oop, but he did. Good alley-oop that.
He had Leitner coming down on the opposite wing. That cools off Duke. They've made seven of their last 10 shots, and as you saw from the graphic, they're really out shooting Notre Dame in this first half. Starting the game, Duke was third in the nation behind Michigan and Syracuse in field goal shooting.
I'm not trying to hold an audience stick, but I've played too many games here. I coached too many games at South Bend. Notre Dame will make a run at Duke sooner or later, most likely in the second half.
Another turnover as the Irish playing sloppily here in the final 2 minutes of the first half.
We put them up 15.
Abdelnaby from Ferry. Wow. 50-35 Duke. Abdelnaby is 6-for-6 from the floor. Duke has outscored the Irish 10-2 in this run.
Watch Abdelnaby go up here with his left hand for a dunk. Shows me something there. No wonder he was player of the year in New Jersey in 86.
Fallon Snyder was his second. And at the line is Tim Singleton for Notre Dame.
They need these foul shots.
Averaging just under six a game. Notre Dame shooting only 64%. It's been a plague that has hit college basketball. So many good shooting teams are not shooting free throws in the second half, Al. We've got to talk about why is that? Both Duke's only shooting 64%.
One of the things, there's so much scrimmaging and playing outside that no one ever takes foul shots in scrimmage games or playground games. They'll melt the clock a little bit, take it down. Just want to give Notre Dame one possession coming down the court.
Barry can't.
Now they'll give him none. Ah, he shouldn't have taken that. Shouldn't have taken that shot. That was no-no.
Anderson misses, as did Ferry. LaFonso Ellis got the rebound. Ellis with only 5 points in this first half. Misses his shot, gets it back, and a hold on Ferry.
Danny reached in, didn't box out, mad at himself, seems safe.
Check out again. Ellis with only 2 points in this first half. Basket interference, the topic of the State Farm rules of the game, and look to meet a 7'4" high school junior that may be a star of the future in the college ranks out in Utah.
That statement I made about a run, I stay with it. Notre Dame will make a run at Duke. I'm not saying they'll get it down to 3 or 4 points, but I guarantee they'll get under 10 somewhere in the second half.
Ellis looking for only his third point. He's averaging over 15. And Digger got him. He said it's the kind of player that can lead us back to the Final Four. Said that a long time ago, and I think Digger's right.
Well, it's the best freshman class since Orlando Woolridge and Kelly Kapuka.
Tracy Jackson. For Ellis, that's one of the key reasons why Notre Dame is looking at a 14-point deficit. Duke going for the final shot. Abdelnaby, short. Henderson was fouled, reaching in with Singleton. So with 5 seconds to go, Phil Henderson will get a couple of free tosses.
Phil's probably the most improved ball player on the Duke team. I think he has to work on that outside shot a little bit more. I'll
take whoever. Digger Phelps may be working on his halftime speech already. And Mike Krzyzewski has to be happy with the way his club has played here on the road. Digger saying, hey, how much time are they going to take? Come on, get him up there, make him shoot. Henderson looking for his 7th point.
Yep, they pull Ala back now for the long pass. He's just like a free safety back there. There's only 5 seconds left on the clock, you see on the screen. Won't start to the touch. Now I'll leave it up court, guys, to take that court part. You're going to go all the way, son. Put it up.
And it would have counted, but Frederick hits the back of the rim, and Duke sizzling hot the final 5 minutes of this first half, and Notre Dame error prone and not shooting well at all, and that story
reflected on the board at halftime. Duke from the ACC, 52. Notre Dame, 36. Our half, 38%. The Irish were 13th in the nation coming in field goal shooting, 52.3%. And Duke, even above their average, which is third best in the nation at 56%. But the field goal percentage is almost equal to the score in the game, 52-36.
But you know what happened, Dick? They got so many putbacks, easy baskets. That's why they shot 50% that half.
And the big men were a story, and we didn't even include the freshman Christian Leitner, who has 11 points, while Ellis, the star freshman, has only 3, and Keith Robinson, second leading scorer, or third leading, actually, for Notre Dame, averaging over 12 a game, has not scored a point yet. Anderson almost in double figures, but it's been the inside game of Duke, the difference.
I thought one of the problems at Notre Dame is they kept out Robinson and Alfonso Ellis too long in that half.
And Jackson and Frederick, much of their points, really one-on-one moves, having to work their way inside.
So a complete mismatch the first half on the baseline. But you will see, I believe, a different Notre Dame team this half.
The Irish will get the ball first. And undoubtedly, some ears were burned at halftime by their coach, Digger Phelps. Singleton, Ellis, Frederick, Jameer Jackson, and Robinson. Henderson on Frederick. Snyder has Singleton.
He won't shoot from out there. He'll try to penetrate. There it is.
Tough shot against his body going away, and Ferry collects another rebound. Yeah, that's a present. But he had more. Taken away. Jackson. Singleton. Frederick. And a whistle. Abdelnaby gets the call. His second.
Won't be a two-shot foul. If Frederick would have put that shot up that time, even after the whistle, it would have gotten two foul shots. So remember that, you young people out there. When you hear a whistle, shoot the ball up towards the glass.
In to Jameer Jackson, and another foul, this time Snyder reaching in. His third. And Robert Bricky sent in by Mike Krzyzewski for Duke, and will replace John Smith. John Smith comes out. I asked Jameer Jackson, his grandmother, Hattie Jackson, is 95 years old, is 95 about a month ago. She's down in Marianna, Arkansas. If she'd be watching today, and said, he says, I don't know, she'll only watch one channel. If we're not on that channel, she won't see me. The woman of her ways.
That's nice. I have a hang up when people have glass backboards in their driveway. I just can't accept it. So I know I'm wrong. I'm from yesteryear.
Well, the Irish get the first 2 points of the second half.
Pressure will be a little more intense. Alfonso Smith is playing back a one-man zone. We should go to Ollie. There he is. He's free.
And now they'll set it up with the Snyder, the point man. Everything revolves around that man, Danny Ferry.
Whatever you want, inside, outside, passing.
Berry. Mayor Jackson, 6-2, gets the rebound.
Nice pass.
Robinson, no whistle. Robinson has his first bucket of the game, and it's 52-40. First 4 points to Notre Dame in the second half.
1-2-1 pressure. Broken.
Traveling against Bricky.
Good call. Good call timeout then by Coach K. Pro call timeout. He called a timeout after 1 minute and 45 seconds. He knows what this crowd can do.
This is a change. This is new. Howard Johnson, can this be you?
Johnson today. This is Howard Johnson today.
This is Howard Johnson today.
Changing in so many colorful, comfortable, welcoming ways.
This is Howard Johnson today. This is Howard Johnson today.
It's White Tag Days at your Mazda dealers, and the deals are really fine on MX-6 and RX-7. Tag for factory-to-dealer incentives that can save you hundreds. On 929, MPV, and 626. Great availability means they're tagged to move fast. And every Mazda truck and 323 is tagged for big cash back from Mazda.
These super RX-7 savings are for a limited time only. Come drive one home today.
We're looking for a few good men with a medal to be Marines.
The people who count on my brakes are important to me. So the people who work on my brakes are important to me.
The people who work on your brakes at Midas are trained brake experts. Remember, nobody beat Midas. Nobody.
Six-time Player of the Year Tom Watson, Paul Azinger, and a field of golfing greats tee off at the Hawaiian Open next weekend on NBC.
Notre Dame trailing by 16 at the half, but the Irish get the first 4 points of the second half and then a turnover. Coach Mike Krzyzewski of Duke calling a quick timeout, and it's Notre Dame's ball. Conclusion of today's game, will be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team, and Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of each university.
Look at your screen there. It's a 1-2-1 trapping zone with Robinson all the way back playing a one-man zone. Robinson's in the back. There's the trap. Got better. Here's the trap again. Now it's broken. It should be a three-point. It didn't take.
Berry driving. Can't hit. Jackson, three-on-one break. The foul against Ellis. Ellis was fouled as he tried to go up for that shot. That denied him an easy two.
All right. Henderson catches a piece of him, which is a good place. Here he caught a little piece that time, and Ellis, he'll end up getting two shots from the charity line. And here we go, maybe under 10, and in comes that sixth man, which this place is famous for. It's like a, I used to try so hard on that coach here to keep the student body out of the game. Rebound.
Ellis gets two, and that's seven unanswered points to open the half for Notre Dame. They cut Duke's lead to 9.
There's a nice shot.
Ellis hits them both. No, 8 in a row for Notre Dame.
How much more aggressive they are on defense. Take this hit. They're scrambling. They're not afraid of foul. They're playing win, not playing not to lose. It's a big difference. Danny wants the ball. They're bouncing him and Robinson. Robinson was a little bit too aggressive on Danny Ferry.
That's his third foul. And the second team foul on Notre Dame in this half. Duke has 3. Duke yet to score in this half. They played nearly 3 minutes.
Smith should pop out for a jumper. Nice move. Didn't move fast enough.
Snyder with a drive. He can't hit. And a foul on Leitner over the back. Well, things are breaking Notre Dame's way. They're forcing the action to come their way. And with 8 straight points, Notre Dame has the ball again. This is the run you predicted, and it comes right at the top of the second half.
It happens every time. You don't come to Notre Dame, they don't make a run at you.
Ellis
Yes.
10 in a row. I was too fast. Slow down now. Get Danny Ferry down low. Get him the ball. There it is. Need a little more patience, the Blue Devils.
Alfonso Ellis ripping down the rebound. Here comes Singleton. The game is 52-46.
If they score, they should call another timeout.
Got a break. Ellis steals it from Ferry after Ferry had rebounded Ellis's missed shot.
Push and shove.
What happened that time, Dick, is that Ellis is so excited, he wants the crowd in the game. Danny Ferry started to get into the game and pushed Ellis. Digger Phelps knows he's got the momentum going. He's got, watch the pushing and shoving here. Now watch Ellis. See that enthusiasm? There's the elbow on his chest by Ferry. Good call by the Zebra. Well, Ferry gets the foul, and it's 52-46, six-point game for Duke.
Out it comes to Alfonso Ellis. Here in the second half, Notre Dame outscoring Duke 10-0. The first 4 minutes. Is it 12? Frederick?
Yes! He got away with a charge that time. I think we need another timeout, Duke. Settle down. Go slow. Set up. He palmed the ball. Frederick hit him on the hip before. It looked to me like Smith might have palmed the ball that time.
A 12-point run for Notre Dame to take a game that was all in Duke's favor at the intermission, right back into a tight contest. 4-point lead for Duke. They had led 52-36, 16 points at halftime.
Nice position.
Abdelnaby, that'll be goaltending on Ellis.
Doesn't have to worry about the goaltending, Dick. Ellis hit the backboard. If you hit the backboard while the ball's in the air, it's automatic basket good.
So Duke finally scores after 4 minutes and 7 seconds of the second half. Joe Frederick is open. Abdelnaby has the rebound.
Wait, I played some game today.
He has played
outstanding.
Big.
Outstanding.
Maybe they got the composure back now.
Snyder, no one picked him up, and a good block by Ellis. 3-on-3, the numbers aren't quite there, but Singleton goes in, and the block by Abdelnaby, and Ferry controls.
Digger's upset because Ala hit the backboard that time. The basket should have been good. Double team. Now a solid man-to-man. Duke look the ball, get the ball down low to Danny or Ala.
Duke playing into the student body end in the second half. Ferry. 56-48. Ferry leads all with 15 points. To go here at Notre Dame.
Digger might have to move in some subs.
That's going to be called blocking.
Boy, that was a tough call. Could have gone either way. Abdelnaby has his third foul. Sixth team foul on Duke already in the second half.
Here's a shot of the block. It's a hairline call. Could have went either way. Digger finally moved in the sub. He has to keep him fresh if he wants to stay in this ball game, because Duke is a thoroughbred in collegiate basketball.
Scott Paddock replacing Keith Robinson.
All right. No, he made a mistake there. Joey made a mistake. You can catch the ball in the back court as long as you haven't touched it in the front court.
Now he knows. You can just see it on his face. He knew he didn't have to try to flip it back.
That's okay, he said. I'll get you next time. Gotta put it up.
Ferry over Ellis. Paddock kicked it out. Singleton, Paddock left alone. 9 points for Scott Paddock. Danny Danny Ferry quiets the crowd for a moment with his 17th point.
Give me the ball. Give me the ball. Danny Ferry's the big brother.
Yeah, we've seen him all 4 years, and he just has grown taller each year, hasn't he?
In every way.
Foul is on Smith. I mean, you can't stop a move like this.
Well, watch him take a jump two-step here. Watch. Now, here's the jump step. He jumps up, gets planted, gets his balance automatically.
Using that body to shield away from the defender. Maybe something if his dad gets a chance to, and it conceivably could happen, that the Bullets could draft Ferry. Father could be...
Wouldn't be the best thing in the world for Danny
Ferry. No, it would be best for him.
Everybody likes to get with a winner, and presently they're not a winner.
Jameer Jackson at the line looking for his 12th point. And that could be an important statistic as Notre Dame with only three team fouls and the Irish already into the bonus.
With over 13 minutes left, to be exact, 13 minutes and 36 seconds. Here comes another sub in for Notre Dame. If there's a problem here, I just don't think Dick is making enough substitutions. Oh, here comes another one off the bench. It was time.
Jackson looking for his 13th point. That's his average on the year. 58-52. Jackson comes out. Sweet and Bennett, the Texas connection, come in. Couple of freshmen, one from Beaumont, the other from Houston.
Both are quick. They can turn the ball over, and they're fresh.
Ferry helping out in the press. He just does everything. Henderson. Good defense by Paddock.
That's a walk. If you catch the ball and go down with the ball in your hands, it's an automatic call for a walk.
So trailing by six. The Irish head up court. 13 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Elmer Bennett. Boy, he had a big game against UCLA. We saw here on NBC Sports.
I think we should get the ball down low to Robinson.
Frederick.
Oh, a victory lap.
The Irish trail by four with just under 13 to go. Frederick with 14.
Three-point land. And he was fouled.
Bennett fouled him, and Danny Ferry for a rare four-point opportunity.
And was it needed? You talk about a javelin to the heart. That was it.
The Irish climbing from a 16-point deficit at halftime to within four, and then Ferry drills a three-pointer and gets a chance now to make it a four-point play.
And again, it won't be long, but when a guy takes a three-point field goal shot and gets fouled, he'll end up taking three foul shots. That's what it should be.
Four-point play for Ferry. 21 points in the game for Danny.
Key point right here. Notre Dame has to score. Otherwise, Duke can get a run going. Uh-oh, here it comes.
Stolen by Davis. And he can't hit the slam, but was fouled. Elmer Bennett. Two quick fouls on him.
Ricky has no fear. This is no fear.
Him what he high jumped in high school, and I said, you're 6'5, how high'd you go? He said, well, he said, I only went 6'6. I said, how come only? He said, well, I'd wait till all the other guys could make the height. Whatever that was, I'd jump it, and the tallest it ever was 6'6.
Well, he has cat-like quickness. He's an unsung hero. I don't hear much about him.
Average 12 points a game on the year. He has only two today, but he's not shooting. It's Ricky is shooting. It's tough shooting into that crowd.
He's shooting into the zoo. I went to the animal fair. The birds and the bees were there. And the big baboon.
You know that was an Irish song? 64-54.
The monkey, he got drunk. He fell on the elephant's trunk. The elephant sneezed, went down to his knees, and that was the end of the monk, the monk, the monk.
Help me, help me. Jameer Jackson can't hit. And with a 10-point lead, Duke.
Ricky, timeout, Notre Dame. I told you that 4-point play would do it. You didn't have your patience going back.
Now up by 12 is Duke. 12 minutes to go.
Should call a timeout.
Right at a TV timeout. Stinger trying to save it. Frederick hits. Frederick with 16 to lead Notre Dame. Stinger knows there'll be a timeout the next time the clock is stopped. What he did in rallying Duke against Georgia Tech earlier in the week. The engineer survived down in Atlanta, but not to any fault of Danny Ferry. He did everything but put the points on the board himself. 5 seconds to Snyder, Hawking, Tim Singleton, and with that, a timeout, the television timeout. The Danny Ferry Show.
Yep. This could be the MVP in the country. Murders from inside, but kills you from outside.
How fast does Dristan nasal spray start to work?
Faster than Dolly can pick up a $5 tip.
Dristan works fast to relieve nasal congestion, even sinus pressure. For relief,
faster than a fan on a hot day.
Try Dristan nasal spray. It's faster than...
Caught you. Another Burger King special, right?
Huh?
Now their quarter pound double cheeseburger is just 99 cents, right?
Right, 99 cents.
With my delicious flame raw taste, two slices of melted cheese, and now a great 99 cent price. These burgers are awesome. I'm doomed. Good thing it's for a limited time.
How did you know about this 99 cent special?
Daddy's home for Burger King.
I have my sources.
99 special at Burger King.
You've seen those Chevy versus Ford tests, right? We came up with one of our own. Half-ton 4x4s, best available tires, driven at the same identical speed right through this 18-inch deep ditch. Now, this is a real control test, so don't you try it, because you'll damage your truck. That's the Chevy with torsion bar suspension, and that's the Ford with twin traction beam suspension. And you can see why we've had a change of heart and pickup.
That's today's Chevy truck.
There are headaches.
And the car payment is overdue.
And headaches. There's aspirin. And Anacin. The Anacin aspirin formula relieves headaches better than regular aspirin.
Feeling better, hon?
Not just better. Better.
Anacin. Better relief.
Next weekend, come home to all the excitement of college basketball. Saturday, the 1988 national champion Kansas Jayhawks battle the Missouri Tigers, or Florida meets Kentucky. Then next Sunday, the running rebels of UNLV battle NC State. College basketball, it's the stuff weekends are made of on NBC Sports.
Earlier this year against the University of Miami, Ferry scored 58, a new Atlantic Coast Conference record, breaking David Thompson's mark of 57. They called him Hurricane Danny after his effort down there against Miami. All he did was go 23 of 26 from the floor and 10 of 12 from the line. 58 points, of course, that shattered Dick Groats' Duke record. Former great infielder with the Pirates, was also a super shooter for Duke in the 50s.
Well, Duke was all in 1953. Duke was one of the leading assists. I think he's behind Tommy Amaker, the kid that sits on the bench now as a graduate assistant. And the third guy is the Twin Snyder that's out there playing.
Snyder with the ball. Lobbing to Ferry. Good control. And Ferry now with 26 points. They're almost back to their halftime lead, up by 15 with 10:43 to go.
They might have run out of juice, Notre Dame. I knew they'd take that run. Got it down to 4, wasn't it?
4 points. They scored only 2 points since that run. And another turnover, Leitner. And Davis scores, and he is fouled. Brian Davis. Look at that Duke bench. They're really fired up. They're hungry for a win. You were right this morning when you tried to go into their breakfast meeting.
I just looked in. I didn't walk in. I could see by their eyes. I said, this is not my place to be an MC. I give them a couple of these one-liners.
Joe Frederick picks up his third foul. And a three-point chance for Brian Davis. Number 23, Brian Davis from Ledgesburg, Maryland. averaging just two a game, and he gets three on that effort. He'll come out as Phil Henderson back in.
This whole run came about because of that four-point play. Danny Ferry hit a three-point field goal with a foul shot.
Henderson, and the Blue Devils threatening to blow this one wide open if they haven't already, as we're at the midpoint of this second half. They have outscored Notre Dame 14, make that 18-2.
Dick is very upset over there. Excuse me, Dick. He might end up with a T. I thought there'd be some T's here. Nope. Digger might go back to the Green Carnation.
It was 58-54 Duke when Ferry made that four-point play, and sparked by that, Duke has outscored the Irish 18-2. We'll return after these words from your local station.
A midnight caller, sex for hire runaways.
Why'd you let them do this to me?
Looking for a way out.
You want to tell me about it?
Pitting Jack against a ruthless porn king, Tuesday.
Computer companies, software companies, they're a dime a dozen.
You got it.
Telephone companies, there must be 1,000 of them.
True.
So why is it always 9X?
Hey, you want 12 brands of software and computers?
Plus, please.
Plus 100 years of telephone experience in one company?
Yeah, yeah.
That's 9X.
So without 9X, I suppose hell would freeze over? Need to communicate.
In their hearts, they're enemies.
That is the other half of your team, the pride of Mother Russia.
In the air, they're allies.
They trained us to target these people, not rub wings with them.
Lou Gossett Jr. is back in Iron Eagle 2, coming soon on video cassette.
Red Heat. Arnold Schwarzenegger, a Soviet cop with his own kind of style. James Belushi, a Chicago cop with no style at all. With this much friction, there's got to be heat. Red Heat, now on video cassette.
Al's Diet, starting Tuesday at 6 on News 4 New York.
Yeah, Duke has taken aim on Notre Dame. 18-2 run in college basketball is brought to you by the heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. And by Wendy's Old Fashioned Hamburgers, the best burgers in the business. Well, the Irish fired up by Notre Dame. Head coach Diggerfeld said halftime came out with a 12-point run, but now it's Duke's turn, 18-2. You look at other scores. Huge game in the Big Ten, Iowa and Illinois and Arizona. Top team on the West Coast continuing to win. West Virginia looking for its 16th straight. That's the longest current winning streak in the nation. Joe Frederick. The three is not there. Oh, Ricky flying for that rebound.
The only Achilles heel that Ricky has is his outside shooting.
And he's been playing more outside this year, where last year played well and comfortably inside. Ferry left alone.
What a clinic the guy's putting on today. I got to move him closer to Purvis Ellison. I still think Purvis Ellison's number one so far.
We saw Stacey King in that brilliant show up to 46-48 against Las Vegas, and Ferry writing his own text today.
There's no player in college basketball that plays like Ferry. They're just, inside, outside, pass, play defense, and a team leader.
He'll have another 100 assists again this year. He's had 100 assists the last 3 years. Such a thoughtful, he grew up in a basketball. His dad, played 10 years in the NBA, Bob?
And it's like a Peace Corps guy or girl that goes, he could have went last year and been in the top three in the draft in the NBA. He says, no, let me get my degree. Let me set an example for the young people out there.
He also took out $1.5 million in insurance.
Yeah, you should.
business is business. Still, you go to school to get a degree.
And that's been the pattern with Duke under Krzyzewski. Every player has graduated. Of course, if Kenny Denard, who was not one of Krzyzewski's players, was the only one going back a long span, 10, 12 years, who didn't have his degree, and the other players pressured him in going back to school and getting his degree.
Well, the same with Notre Dame, with Digger, that anyone that's been a senior, they have 61 seniors, they've all gotten their degrees.
75 for Duke. It's 42 of 42 basketball players have graduated.
Like Talk the Shark says, but if you go to Duke or Notre Dame, you're supposed to get a degree.
Chuck Leitner has 13.
He says, what's so good about that? You know what? He's pretty right.
Another 5-second call. Close defense. And Duke has said this run is just manhandling Notre Dame at every phase of the game.
Give Quinn Snyder the credit. It's the second time he did it. Hey, you're looking at a club now that's been to two of the last three Final Fours. That's an impossible dream. But they're dreaming about going to the trifecta, the third one.
Beaten by Kansas in the semifinals last year, and Kansas going on to take Oklahoma.
The year before that, they were beaten by in the Sweet 16 by Indiana, who won the NCAA.
Ferry, it'll go against Ferry, no basket.
They had to take something away from Danny. He's getting we're not playing on a level field anymore.
Third foul on Ferry.
Four-point to a 22-point spread in less than 5 minutes. And the student body has left us.
Yeah, we haven't had much to cheer about. 4 points since that run. 4 points in 7-8 minutes. Barry. It's a tough shot for most players. Henderson with a near steal, and then he gets the foul. Four on Phil Henderson.
Number three, Phil Henderson.
Well, we're going to see Duke again down the line against North Carolina in the rematch. That'll be at Chapel Hill. And, of course, the ACC tournament on NBC.
Also returning for Duke.
Like so many leagues, from top to bottom. Every team has got talent. Every game is a contest.
Look at our games next weekend, Dick. We got Kansas at Missouri on Saturday. Then on Sunday, we got UNLV at North Carolina State.
And coming into this game, you couldn't have convinced me that at this stage it would be a 21-point game. This one figured to be very tight, but the Irish caught Duke, a team that losing 4-5, came here in an angry mood. They came here to play big, and they have.
And they got to get ready for Virginia on Wednesday night. Virginia is upset minor. He's going all the way. Oh, he can leave. Oh, I hope we get a replay of that. Did he go upstairs? He went through the sound barrier. That could be three.
Patrick does hit the three. For Joe Frederick, who has saved some of his best games for Duke. Abdel Nabi bringing the ball up and turns it over.
Here he goes. We won't say anything.
You guys want to be guards. Come on.
He's only 6'5".
Seven minutes, 10 seconds to go. Another three-point try. Jackson. That's 6 points in a hurry for the Irish. With 18. 7 minutes to go. Duke still very much in command. A 16-point lead.
Get Danny Ferry back in, and the game is over.
Davis sets up Abdel Nabi. Foul Robinson. Four on Keith Robinson, who has been a non-factor in this game today. 2 points. And LaFonso Ellis has only 7 points, so 9 points from those two big men inside. Ellis.
Kay just turned around and said to us, when's the next TV timeout? I have no idea. One thing you got to remember in TV games, each team only gets 4 timeouts. In a game that's not on TV, each team gets 5 timeouts.
Abdelnaby looking for his 15th point. In comes Danny Ferry. Abdelnaby goes out. Mike Krzyzewski, Digger Phelps, Digger's parents watching from Powden Beacon, New York, and Mike Krzyzewski's mom is here with his brother just behind us.
Spoke to her early. She's 77 years of age this week.
Singleton. And a foul. Third foul on Singleton. And the Ferry indicating just the wind knocked out of Smith.
Watch the knee. See where the knee catches Smith? That's what knocked the wind out of him.
They didn't count the basket.
The ball has to be released before you make contact for the basket to count.
Ferry working the backcourt. Snyder almost lost it.
Nice call, timeout that time. Save the five count. That's what seniors can do. They're thinking.
Duke with that timeout, 6:28 to go. And Mike Krzyzewski's Devils about to win an important game.
Heavy hitter from field operations takes over. Wants to move us into the Fortune 100. Tough guy. He wants to look at MIS. How many computers? How many dollars? What's the return? So I show him what we're doing with Wang. Voice response for order status. Wang integrated imaging for customer service. Field to home office integration. The numbers from the field come into the mainframe the second the books close. Consolidated financials go back to the field by the third of the month. His jaw drops. He says, well, he didn't say anything really. He just whistled, like...
America wants to haul, tow, or just have big loads of fun. Chevy Astro's the van that can.
The heartbeat of America.
Chevrolet. That's today's Chevrolet.
In their hearts, they're enemies.
That is the other half of your team, the pride of Mother Russia.
In the air, they're allies.
They trained us to target these people, not rub wings with them.
Lou Gossett Jr. is back in Iron Eagle 2, coming soon on videocassette.
Red Heat. Arnold Schwarzenegger, a Soviet cop with his own kind of style. James Belushi, a Chicago cop with no style at all. With this much friction, there's got to be heat. Red Heat, now on video cassette.
If you've ever dreamed the dream of a champion, now your sports fantasy may come true on NBC Sports World.
If you've ever dreamed the dream of a champion, now your sports fantasy may come true on NBC Sports World next Sunday.
11 years ago, and Digger Phelps, the loser in the Tom Jones look-alike contest, and his Irish, their only trip to the Final Four in St. Louis, met Duke in the semifinals, and the Blue Devils with the Jaminski and Spinarkle, Denard and company, Banks, beat the Irish 5-4. That was a great Notre Dame team with Trepucka and Jackson, Hanslick, Duck Williams, Batten, Flowers, Lambeer. But it was Duke 92-86, and then Duke would lose in the finals to Kentucky.
Digger looked that time like Jimmy Valvano.
That was the time of the hair, wasn't it, in the 70s. What can we add to it?
Let's not talk about that.
83-66, Duke with the lead and the ball, and they'll play it patiently now.
Going to what we call a delay or a B pattern. Milk it down 25 seconds. Look to get Notre Dame into 1-1.
10 seconds on the shot clock. Henderson with 6. Ferry with 5. Back to Henderson, who scores even though he was fouled. Ferry again with the assist. 12 points for Henderson.
Playing a simple 2-3 zone. Nice move by Jameer.
Oh, tough two for Jameer Jackson, who has 20 points. Frederick and Jackson have been really the only scoring for Notre Dame in this game. 20-19.
Coach K is standing up. See him there on the bottom of the screen? Spread it out. Make it work. You say spread it out and move that clock. I want to win. We need a win. Let's get that momentum going for Virginia at home on Wednesday. Or Tuesday, I'm not sure.
Davis. Barry can't get the rebound. Here comes Frederick for Notre Dame. Jackson again loses the ball. Davis flips it to Bricky. 4 minutes and 40 seconds to go.
Got to remember, Dick, that Kevin Ellery is not eligible anymore. Became an academic casualty at the end of the semester.
Yeah, the pit bull, they called him, and wide body, tough player. He'll be missed.
Sure, he was averaging about 6 points a game.
Plenty of time in the shot clock, 20 seconds.
Coach K won't sit down.
Bricky. Easy two for Bricky as he goes around Robinson for his 10th point. At the other end, Robinson trickles it in. 87-70 the score. 4 points for Keith Robinson.
They say an easy, easy, take it across and back it up. The Duke bench is up. They're like it's a two-point game rather than the 17-point lead with less than 4 minutes to go.
Ricky gets around Robinson again, but doesn't take the shot. Almost throws away. It's the shot clock. 45-second clock you see in the left corner. And the game clock now down to 318, 317.
Ricky's in good position down low.
Davis, a flying one-hander. Ryan Davis with 5 points.
Notre Dame got to regroup. They play Fordham later in the week at Madison Square Garden in New York City.
Got Georgia Tech on the road. They've got a couple with DePaul, the team that we saw win impressively yesterday against North Carolina State. Fourth foul on Frederick. You know, Coach, on that free throw, the fact that here are good teams shooting. I mean, good teams should shoot in the 70s in free throw shooting. That team's Duke and Notre Dame both 64%. One of the things we're talking to Digger Phelps about is the fact that the three-point shot means that that's a different shot than a free throw. That's an energy shot. A free throw is a relaxed 15-footer, and then all the rest is inside. So unlike the game of 10 years ago where you worked for the 15-footer, you did a lot of passing and picks, as your teams did. I mean, the free throw is almost a new experience. You're there flat and you know, that range.
I really think the key to it is concentration and not to psych the bad free throw shooters out of it. They just get over there and practice on their own, assign an assistant coach to them. And the other thing is that so much play is outside of the program, they don't get enough practice.
Timeout with 2 minutes and 51 seconds to go, and some of the fans are doing just that, going here at Notre Dame.
This is your executive section.
Executive section.
This is your welcoming gift.
Welcoming gift?
This is your newly decorated room.
This is Howard Johnson?
Uh-huh. Howard Johnson.
We're back with another test of Chevy versus Ford. And this one you can do at home. Just load both trucks with eggs and lower something heavy down on them. You'll see that Chevy has these notches that let you do double-deck loading. You'll see that Ford doesn't have any notches. That's why we've had a change of heart about pickups. With Ford, you can bring home the bacon. With Chevy, you can bring home the bacon and the eggs.
The heartbeat of America. That's today's Chevy truck.
Winter's beautiful. She's just not real friendly sometimes. The days get shorter. The cold makes things kind of brittle. And the boys, well, they just get uglier. But come nightfall, when the fire gets hot, you still get thirsty.
Bush.
Winter's not so bad.
Head for the mountains of Bush. Beer.
What's cooking at Wendy's? Our new Philly Swiss burger with fresh peppers, onions, and mushrooms. All on a Kaiser bun. Come on in and grab one while it's hot.
It is here that the true mettle of a man is tested. For a few days in March, the Players' Championship on NBC Sports.
Hey, what's say, Governor? Max Crowder, he's the trainer for Duke. This is his 801st consecutive game. 27 straight years without missing a game. Now, there's a guy who could write a book. Drive and unsuccessful is Elmer Bennett just into the game. We haven't seen much of Bennett. He's the one that really caught our eye out at UCLA, but not much duty today.
This is true with a freshman team, a young team. One day they're sky high, the next day they're crying in the locker room. The best thing about a freshman team is to become a sophomore team.
And they'll be a good team. Phil Henderson leaves with 5 fouls and 14 points. Solid play. And here's Elmer Bennett from Bel Air High School in Houston, where he led the state of Texas in scoring last year and as a junior. Averaged 30 points a game as a junior and nearly 36 a game as a senior, and earned the Texas Mr. Basketball title.
At one time, Dick, in 3 consecutive high school games, he scored 49 points, 48, and 42.
And he can fly. He's as fast as any collegiate guard in the game. His first points. 91-72, the Blue Devils, and the foul as LaFonso Ellis came out, picked up his third foul.
LaFonso Ellis just third. Notre Dame returning number 3, Joe Frederick, replacing
second. Well, the Irish had lost only 3 games coming in of their first 15 and had some impressive wins. UCLA, Kentucky, Indiana. They did lose at San Francisco. They lost to Valparaiso in overtime and then lost here at home to Syracuse. But this will be the toughest one for Digger to swallow.
Well, still a young team. You know, they never should lose to Valpo or San Francisco. They started up a new program out there. But that's what happens, a roller coaster.
Ricky with 11 points, 10 in the second half. Oh, what a steal. Ryan Davis, then Bennett takes it right back from him, and then the foul by Bricky. And in case you just joined us, Duke playing great basketball for 40 minutes. 5 players in double figures, and All-America Danny Ferry leading the way with 28 points, 6 boards, 6 assists, and 4 steals. Ellis and Robinson, that combination, the big men inside for Notre Dame, only 11 points in the game. Ferry alone outscoring them by 17, and that's the story as Duke leads by 21.
You know, Professor, this kid here has a 3.6 grade point average. That's high.
At any place, especially a school of Notre Dame.
Someday you'll see him on that GTE Academic All-America.
I like those kids. I like being associated with them. Bennett, 4 in a row from the line. It's interesting even here with the press on, who takes the ball out? Ferry does. He'll make good choices. Got that height so he can throw that high pass over his head. 2-on-1. Greg Kubek is fouled.
Greg Kubek has been in a drought lately. He seems to have lost his outside shot.
4th foul on LaFonso Ellis. Yeah, he was recruited as a 3-point shooter and showed flashes of excellence last year as a freshman, but as a sophomore, Kubek a little disappointed with himself, averaging just 5 points a game and shooting only 38%. And looking for his first point today. He's from Clifton Park, New York, north of Albany. He was the co-high school player of the year in the state of New York with King Rice, who went to North Carolina.
He's taller than he looks. They have him down at 6 foot six. He looks around 6'3" out there.
2:12 to go. Damon Sweet. Crowd was making more noise when the Glee Club was on at halftime. Timeout with 2:04 left. Digger Phelps calls time. 18 points down to Duke.
Express mail from your post office has a whole fleet of 727.
We deliver, we deliver.
A guaranteed morning delivery.
We deliver, we deliver.
And an overnight price of just $8.75.
We deliver, we deliver.
Speed, convenience, price. It's a package only we can deliver. Express mail from your postal service.
We deliver for you.
Next weekend, come home to all the excitement of college basketball. Saturday, the 1988 national champion Kansas Jayhawks battle the Missouri Tigers, or Florida meets Kentucky. Then next Sunday, the running rebels of UNLV battle NC State. College basketball, it's the stuff weekends are made of on NBC Sports.
No surprise here, the Chevrolet Most Valuable Players, Danny Ferry for Duke and Jameer Jackson with 20 points for Notre Dame. Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and also to assist those in financial need. Ferry and Jackson are MVPs today.
Just beat the five count on the money.
Couldn't inbound Dick, the ball.
Notre Dame football, for the third straight year, freshman class is rated number one in the country. Yeah. Football again.
And they join a number one team in the country. You know, no one has ever, we were mentioning, won both a school football and basketball championship in the same year. But one team came very, very close just a year or two ago.
I know. Oklahoma.
The Sooners. They played Miami for the football championship in the Orange Bowl and played Kansas in the NCAA final in the same year. So the Sooners were a game away from the impossible double.
Lou Holtz, 3 years in a row, bringing in the best freshman class of all college football. That means don't book Notre Dame in football.
They still got to beat Miami at Miami next year. Frederick with his 21st point. 94-78.
Notre Dame looking to foul. Duke trying to just eat the clock up and get the game over with.
Ferry. He has great vision. Spreading the court, moving the ball around, chewing up the clock, not allowing Notre Dame to foul. Snyder to Kubek, and he is fouled. Alfonso Ellis stopping the easy two. Coach, come up with something here. How about some scores? Oh, okay, how about some scores?
There's a team that I said earlier, Villanova has a problem. Georgetown's an outstanding ball club. I think that Syracuse is in class of the Big East. I think that Georgetown is second. Kentucky, I said that Eddie Sutton will be back as coach next year. Did you hear that? Okay. Arizona has the potential of being number one in the country. Lou Holtz has a dynasty going out there in the desert.
Lou Holtz does?
Not Lou Holtz.
Lou Holton.
Yeah, Illinois will be flat, not only because they lost Gill, they're flat because they lost another kid called Kaufman 2 weeks ago with a blood clot in his left arm. You can't lose guards. College basketball is governed by the guards. Pro basketball is governed by the guy down in the paint. How much more do you want? You want me to keep going? I get the biggest joke about people think I don't know basketball.
You're
I got more basketball than these people.
That's right.
I made my life this way, Dick. This is how I paid for food. I used to bring teams in here to South Bend. We would just silence them the same way Coach K has silenced them here today. You think that's easy? It's not easy. Just go to the cities and get my ball players. If you've got grass in front of your home, I can't recruit your son or your daughter. But you live in a high-rise a tenement, I got you.
And you try to get the mom in the kitchen, right?
And I'm telling you this, my ball players got degrees before it was fashionable, Dick. It's fashionable the last 15 years, Professor, and everybody's talking about it, all right?
Okay.
You want
I asked for it.
Okay. You asked.
Uncle.
All right. Because I'm a little bit upset the last couple of weeks.
I just feel like I'm not being hugged enough.
Okay, all right. Well, maybe it's the fact your wife's in Florida. Why don't you ever come home? 96 to 80 the score, a minute and 10 to go. The previous messages that in no way reflects the views of NBC Sports or those working with Coach Al McGuire. Davis. 6 points for him.
Pull another man off the foul line there because they don't want to commit a foul. They want the game over. Let's get back to Durham.
With five Irish players there, almost got the rebound. Homer Bennett. Rebound Frederick. Davis. Kubek.
Kicking
three on one. Snyder to Kubek. Nicely done.
You young ball players out there, always give the ball to the ball handler, then you'll get it back for layup.
Keith Atkins taking his first shot from outside. Snyder.
It's showtime. A little bit of mustard now.
Down to 31 seconds. Kubek, they're trying to set up Kubek, aren't they? Jameer Jackson committed the foul with 29 seconds to go.
Kubek took a little walk before he was hit.
Thanks to Elliot Kalb, our statistician. And the rundown, those who make our telecast possible, the executive producer of NBC Sports, Michael Weissman, coordinating producer of NBC's basketball and director today, George Finkel. Today's game was produced by Kenneth Roy Edmondson. Update produced by Les Dennis. Update directed by Mary Buta Venuccio. And technical director Stephen Cimino and Richard Sansevier. Snow is blowing in northern Indiana. And the Irish were as cold as the weather against this fine Duke team. 100-80. Atkins. Right there. Palmer rebounds just in the game. Up to Buckley. Ricky to Buckley. Clay Buckley, his daddy, was a great star in the ACC with Duke.
102 points. Syracuse scored 99. The record set by Indiana, 106.
And there's the final buzzer. Any other last stats you want to get in there? Come on, you're on a roll. We got 29, 28 seconds. Mike Krzyzewski's Duke Blue Devils win their 15th against only four defeats in a commanding fashion, led by Danny Ferry. Ferry with 28 points in the game. And they outscore Notre Dame 102-80. A low spot for Digger Phelps, who congratulates the team on a fine effort.